We've made something rather useful. I just assume everybody over there sounds like Winston Churchill. That's just me. All right, let's take a look. You've got to love that accent. We've had fewer showers during the day today, and most of our rain was a little bit more to our west, and even that was not as extensive. So thankfully, our drying trend has continued, but still some scattered showers around. We had a few isolated accumulations, only an 0.08 inch up at Macomb and 0.02 inch at Reserve. Nothing officially at Kenner. And where you see kind of these contours where we actually had a little bit of rain fall. Most of it avoided any of our observing stations, and even that, again, was not as much. So rest of the night dry, and early tomorrow we will be dry. Now, this is our high-resolution model, and it is indicating maybe a little bit more scattered shower, thunderstorm development throughout the afternoon and early evening, then coming to an end by the night. So tomorrow and even Sunday looks to be around a 40 to 50% chance, so a little more than we saw today, but even that is not going to be a washout of a day. So good news if you do have outdoor plans. And actually, mostly cloudy skies did help to keep our temperatures down. We've been in the low to mid 80s all day long, and the dew point's actually not terrible at the moment. A 69 degree dew point makes our humidity 65%. Today's high 86 degrees, so a degree above average, but we didn't have as much rainfall. What we did have is mostly cloudy skies, and just about all locations right now in the 70s, with the exception of Macomb at 77, and dew points upper 60s, low 70s. Not horrible, but certainly not what you would expect the first day of October to feel like. More of a fall feel will return by next week. We'll really lower humidity. We're not going to have any kind of a coolness to the air. Winds pretty breezy out at Belle Chasse, gusting up to 25 miles an hour, but we have had a sustained wind out of the east and southeast all day today, and that's kept the humidity in place. So will fall return? Yes, next week. A cold front is on the way, but before that happens, we will stay warm and humid through the weekend with daily rain chances, and then turn less humid. Front will be on the way by Monday, but you'll start to feel the difference by Tuesday morning. It will be a little bit cooler just because of the drier air, but at least with that less humid air, it'll feel a whole lot nicer. You can see this upper low sitting over New Mexico, bringing dry air across Texas, but still pumping in that tropical moisture across the coast of Texas and Louisiana. That will come to an end by the end of the weekend and early next week as our front moves through and drier air arrives. And what's going to likely keep that dry air in place is this. Big upper low is either going to be anchored over the Tennessee Valley or Mississippi and keep a northwesterly flow aloft. That will keep the dry air in place. This is going only till Wednesday, but the long-range models keep it in place till next weekend, so the drier air will be arriving. Again, not anticipating a great deal of cooler air, but with the less humid air, dew points getting into the 50s and 60s, and that'll last through all of next week. It'll feel a whole lot nicer. A little disturbance still sitting over coastal Texas, helping to keep most of the rainfall there. We had a little bit more yesterday than we did today. And again, the bulk of the rainfall, at least over South Louisiana, was a little bit more to our west. So the rest of the night, dry. Scattered showers developing during the afternoon heating and mainly during the midday afternoon and early evening. That'll come to an end and kind of a similar pattern setting up for Sunday. Great news out in the tropics today, October 1st, our two only named storms, Sam and Victor, look like they're going to remain out over the open Atlantic, so nothing close to home. Now, October can be a busy month for tropical development. These are the number of storms we have seen over Louisiana in October going back to 1850. These are all tracked within 100 miles of New Orleans, and as we've been talking about, we tend to see more tropical storms or weaker hurricanes. The only Category 4 storms we ever saw cross the Louisiana coast in October all formed in September. So now here we are in October. We don't typically get the strong storms, but there is that one exception, Zeta, which was last year, and that was in late part of October. So historically speaking, it is not a very busy second half of the month. Usually, if we're going to see anything, it's going to be in the first half. And thankfully, looking at our 7-day forecast, no tropical troubles. We'll keep our shower chances in place through probably early Monday. Then that drier air makes it feel more comfortable, if not a fall feel, through next week.
All right. Well, the World's Fair, or World Expo, as it's called.